So I think we all know these accidents, like Boeing 737 MAX that crashed multiple times. And that was really a tragedy. Actually, that was a series of a tragedy. And then the reason of this failure is because of state estimation. So actually, I think the controller itself was okay, but the MCAS failed to tell the right information about the pitch angle of the aircraft. And controller relied on the wrong information, like this. So the airplane was climbing with the right pitch angle normally, but the MCAS, the state estimator, thought airplane is pitched up too much. And then that information just blindly fed into this loop. And then controller tried to obviously nose down if this is actually happening. However, the reality is like this. And then controller tried to nose down this normal airplane, and then the airplane crashed. Then this kind of a failure of the state estimation may happen quite easily. So I wrote a bunch of PID controller for this drone, and this is the expected behavior. So you take off, the drone is kind of agile enough to maneuver left and right and tilt left and right to control the speed of it. It's kind of like a drifting, you're racing car game. So it looks, by looking at this, it's kind of like satisfying. However, this is only possible because I was relying on the ground truth Euler angles from the simulation, which we don't have in real life. And then this is the implementation based on the sensor fusion with the incomplete information with the fast maneuver. And this is what happens. Now, yeah, it failed. Actually, it banked to the left too much that it never recovered. Well, the red line is actual ground truth, and then this blue one is what accelerometer-based sensor fusion think the bank angle or roll angle of this drone. That's the correct bank angle, like this. This is reality. However, the sensor, the state estimator thought this is near zero, like it thought it's like, I'm okay, I'm stable enough. So it never recovered from this point. So it failed. And this kind of failure happened because it's based on accelerometer. Actually, the gravitational acceleration is there. If there is a significant amount of linear acceleration because it's moving to the left, then that's the total acceleration there with the gravitational acceleration, with the linear acceleration. So it thinks there's a lot of gravitational acceleration and then a little bit of left side of acceleration. So it thought it didn't tilt too much. That's why it's near zero. So this kind of failure happens even after the sensor fusion algorithm, and that's because the limitation of the sensor itself. This was the point that I wanted to get the velocity information from computer vision, like cameras, because if I take the derivative of the velocity, dv dt is the acceleration, linear acceleration from the camera, right? So if I can correct this ding using the computer vision, that would be great. That's why I started studying for computer vision. So to get started with, I actually bought this book, The Famous Multiple View Geometry in Computer Vision. And then actually, if I open this book, it looks like this, and then say, well, this is actually only chapter 2.2, and then it's talking about satellite. Note that the expression X transpose L is just in the inner or scalar product of the two linear. I mean, like, come on, this is only chapter 2. This wasn't the right way to get started. So in this video, let me talk about an easier point to get started with the computer vision to get the physical information over your robot. So you don't really need to start from deep learning, or you don't need to study the complex math, although I recommend that you deep dive further as you go. But to get started with, starting from an easier point doesn't really hurt anyone. So let's start. Oh, by the way, if you're new to here, my name is Elliot, and I'm a robotics engineer, educator, and entrepreneur providing the related services. So by now, you might be wondering, like, monocular camera, because it's a single camera, is much easier to get started compared to the stereo camera. That's what I thought. So, however, I think the stereo camera is much easier than monocular camera. There are several reasons why, but here's another benefit of the stereo camera, because what we as a robotics engineer, we want to get the actual physical properties like acceleration to fix the accelerometer. So we want to have the exact physical property of it instead of the ratio of the movement. Actually, this is an open-end argument, so if you have different opinion, please comment down below. Now, before we actually get started with, we need to talk about the Euclidean and homogeneous coordinates. So given this kind of camera, then there are three objects, and then this camera uses this pinhole camera model, and along with this visual line coming out from the camera center. Then there's image plane, and then this VX is the real world coordinate here. Then along this visual line, there's image point here. Then this is homogeneous because every single point on this visual line, they are the same point on the image, and that's why they call it homogeneous coordinate. The homogeneous coordinate looks like this kind of pyramid shape, like this. And I didn't like it at the beginning because what kind of freaking coordinate looks like a pyramid, right? But then I just look at this picture, right? They are even worse. They are actually even parallel to with each other, but they meet at a point. So when you define a coordinate, you can define any shape with any coordinate. And then another thing that I have to mention is that we need to actually convert everything into homogeneous coordinate from the Euclidean coordinate, because we are looking at this in terms of Euclidean coordinate, which is just good old fashioned X, Y, Z. Then to convert the Euclidean coordinate X, Y, Z into the homogeneous coordinate, it's actually very trivial. You just need to add one more axis with number one, and all of a sudden that's homogeneous coordinate. And then you do whatever operation here in this homogeneous coordinate, then you can predict image point in the homogeneous coordinate. And then if you want to get the actual pixel location in your image, you need to convert this homogeneous coordinate into the Euclidean coordinate. To do that, you just need to divide W in Python code. To convert Euclidean to homogeneous, you just add 1 at the end of the vector. And then to convert homogeneous to the Euclidean, you divide all the vector with the last element. That's it. And then most of the operation will be done here, which is the image formation trick. So let's talk about word coordinate to the image coordinate in the homogeneous coordinates. So actually, there is a formula doing that. Given X, Y, Z of this white box, and then plug in all these numbers, and then you'll get the pixel location on this image. And then, I know it may look scary, but it's not. This fx, fy, cx, cy is just given parameters, and then it's just going to be another 10-minute video to get this camera intrinsic matrix like this. So let's assume we know all this. And then this is rotation matrix, and then this is the translation of x, y, z for your camera. So if you put your camera as the center of the universe, this rotation matrix is just identity matrix, and then t, x, y, z is just all zeros. So what I mean by that, just plug in all these numbers, and at the end of the day, you just need to calculate this matrix operation with the known objects location for x, y, z, then you will be able to predict the pixel location of that object in the image. It's pretty trivial. For example, there is a white box at 000, and then there's a camera at this position. And then, like I mentioned, you just plug in all these numbers, fx, fy, cx, cy, which is the focal length of your camera, and then this is the half of the width of your image, half height of your image. And then rotation matrix, assume your camera is upright, and then it's just identity matrix, and then translation is like this, because this is a relative position to the box. So you put negative signs here, and then you multiply them, and that is camera parameter matrix. And as you know, the point of this white box in the word is like 000. That's why I put 000, and then you just calculate it without thinking too much about it. And then convert the homogeneous coordinate to the Euclidean coordinate by dividing it like this, and then the red dot is predicted like this. And notice that I load this image after all this prediction. Then I'm just plotting all this, and I was able to exactly predict the pixel location of this known white box. So I was ecstatic when I was able to accomplish this pipeline, because I only need to do inverse calculation in the real life, because if I want to get the velocity of my drone, then I can take a picture of the scene with the camera on my drone, and then if I have pixel images like this, then I can always backtrack this word coordinate. The problem is solved. At least that's what I thought. So this would be the simple inverse calculation. However, it didn't work. And that's because if I look at this camera parameter matrix like this, you take the inverse of it, and the inverse doesn't exist. And do you have any guess why? And that's because this homogeneous coordinate. All the point here on this visual line is exactly same on this image. So you have lost the information about the distance. So it is literally impossible to back calculate 3D coordinate. So this is the point where I want to show the connecting experience of mass and phenomena. So this is the same equation that I showed you in the homogeneous coordinate to predict the image coordinate as x, y, w. And at the end of all this calculation, it's just all the constant here. And then this is an example. And then if you expand this matrix as a form of three equations, it looks like this. And then now, if you try to backtrack the world coordinate like this, because you know the pixel location, you just need to plug in all these numbers like this. You don't have to really follow this, but my point is this. And then reorganize the equation, and then at the end of the day, you are left with x, y, z, w, four unknowns with two equations. So you can't solve it. So this is why the monocular camera can only estimate the ratio between the images. So to solve it, we need two more equations. And we know that these two equations coming from a single camera or single image. So what you want to do is just add one more camera on your robot. And now you have four equations with four unknowns. Now you can solve it. And then if you don't want to solve it manually, just put this in the matrix form and use SVD, which is one line of code in Python. And you can estimate x, y, z, w, the world coordinate of actual target. And I believe this makes a very strong connection between the physical phenomena and the math, because it's mathematically proven that you need two eyes. It is almost impossible if I close one of my eyes and try to match my fingertips. It's quite challenging. We can kind of do it because we have the sensory inputs from our body, but only with the vision is quite difficult to match the fingertips with one eye closed. And that's not just because of our brain or something, it's just physically and mathematically bounded. We need four equations with four unknowns to be able to solve this equation. So if I actually do this, if I have one more images, like two cameras, and then calculate all this, and then the 3D coordinate of the point is like this. Hey, do you remember that this white box was at 000 and this camera was 10 meters away? So this estimation is based on the camera centered, right? So that's why this box is actually in front of a camera by about 10 meters. And this is even accurate because this box's volume is 1 by 1 by 1. So half of this box is actually coming towards the camera. And that's why the distance to the surface of this box is about 9.5 in meters. You can actually estimate the realistic position of x, y, z. And then if you do this for a bunch of points in the images of the stereo images like this, then you can create the 3D point cloud because you can estimate the 3D points for each points in the images. And then if you do that again for the next time frame, then you can compare these two point clouds. So this blue set of the point clouds is from the current frame, and then the red one is the next frame. And then as you can see, these red dots are a little behind of the blue dots. And I think this is really satisfying result because if you are in the car or train, actually the tree goes back if you're moving forward, right? And then the same phenomena is happening here. The blue dots are from previous frame and then red dots are next frame. So you are the camera, and then camera measured all these point clouds with the same pattern kind of moved backward because your car was moving forward in this KITTI dataset. So when I started computer vision, I kind of got sucked into the math black hole by the textbook and also by other trends that research papers talking about monocular camera-based visual odometry. It talks about essential matrix, fundamental matrix, and all this epipolar geometry is kind of weird math to me at the beginning. But and they are really cool. I really recommend that you study them. However, just to get started with the computer vision with this multiple view geometry, just start from a method that's easier to think in your brain. And I think it doesn't hurt anyone. So if you're trying to estimate more realistic like physical values like position and velocity of your robot, I recommend this stereo camera based computer vision first, because I try to do that with the monocular camera first because it sounds easier because it's a single camera, but turn out to be there are a bit more math. Although it turned out to be not that bad, but it's just too much of new information at the beginning, even before getting the velocity information for your robot. So that was another frustrating experience. So I thought, you don't have to go through that like me. And if you think this video is helpful, please like it and then subscribe my channel. This is Elliot. I'll see you around.